Shalom, Pras Teferi Salamta. Okay, so it's October 11th still, and we got our mail, and it's interesting because we actually think this is fun, but it's voting season. It appears to be voting season. It's when you get the most. I guess how could we say this? The most waste of paper. Throughout the whole year. And okay, now we gotta mention this for sure. Okay, it turns out that to make paper out of trees, I don't know the specifics on it, but you know, we're gonna give like rough estimates, you know, so each one receiving this message, due diligence and study up on what we are going to say, because the digits are not going to be all that accurate. But let us just make mention that, excuse me, that when they, it's been said that when they break a tree down, they break down a tree in order to produce paper, that it's only a small percentage, even less than half, that can actually be used to go into paper production. For instance, if they cut a tree down, only 40% of that tree, roughly, can actually be used to produce paper. Not only is that a waste, but paper isn't all that, it doesn't last all that long, right? And even worse is that it takes some of those trees to grow roughly around 20 to 40 to 100 years to reach the size of the tree at the point in which they are cut down. And one solution for this is hemp. Fibers in hemp are really strong, super strong, as a matter of fact, surprisingly strong. And you can grow hemp here in the Imperial Valley or Imperial County, where I am from, supposedly, south border, private, I don't know, incorporation or you know, south border incorporated or something, to be more precise. You could grow hemp all year. You know, we can't because obviously, you know, the feds or whatever, it's like it's illegal, but if it were to be legal and you could, in the conditions that we live under, you could plant hemp all year. You could cut hemp twice a year, and you could do acres and acres of nothing but hemp, and you'll get two cuts every year. And so just do the math. I mean, you cut down one tree that took 100 years to grow, and you only use 40% of the actual tree to produce paper, which is so much inferior to hemp. Well, actually, the only reason the Constitution of the United States is still intact is because it is made of hemp. And so, but you know, that wasn't even, we didn't even think about that till right now. We wanted to make mention how we thought this was like the old school Facebook. You know, you get your little profile picture, you give a brief explanation of what nobody reads, and then depending on who you hire, how much money you got, or how good a liar you are, you come up with a lot of different nonsense, well, just imaginations to pretend to be, I guess, better than what you really are. And then And then the final result is more likes. And so it's funny how we had never thought about it that way. So yeah, voting season. I'm not gonna encourage no one to vote. I mean, it's free will. I have to deal with jury duty and stuff like that, because in ignorance I was convinced that it was patriotic to do so, to do that whole, whatever, I don't want to talk about it. But yeah, we want to make mention that is the Imperial County, Imperial Valley, California, but it's not really called that. If you go, if you Wikipedia, the search will make mention that falsely called, it's the locals refer to it as the Imperial County, and from what we're seeing here, it appears that either it's a conspiracy because even the voter registration office considers it Imperial County as well, or this is false advertisement. Regardless, I mean, whatever it be the case, it stated that this area is recognized as South Border, and so we just wanted to show everyone where we are at in California, Southern California. But it's interesting because the border, we have a what they call a twin city south of the border. So we have Calexico, California on the north of the border, and that would be Calex, like California and Mexico, and then the mirror representation of Calexico is Mexicali, so it's Mexico, California, and so it's California, Mexico, Mexico, California. And then it's interesting because information states that 50 kilometers south of the border still pertains to Imperial Land Company, South Border Incorporated or whatever it is, but it's not even owned by California government or nothing like that. And for instance, if you go up to Coachella Valley, that pertains to Inland Company, and so these are private companies. As a matter of fact, 100 years ago, 110 years ago, they developed an idea, and they were going to fund what they called, I guess, the Imperial Valley. And it was, they hire professionals to convince people to invest in land down here. They start. So basically, this was manufactured, man-made, the area that we live in. And it was manufactured for supposedly agricultural purposes, but honestly, we're thinking that it was the only way that they could steal the water from the Colorado River and put it to use to wherever it is that they're putting it to use, because it ain't here. Although we do waste a lot of water, I will say that. But even more interesting, so the Twin City. So this is kind of like another example of spiritual Egypt and how. It seems that Babylon tries to mimic or redo the past. And so we have the Twin City, and I believe the Twin City and mirror cities have something to do with Memphis, maybe, but Memphis in Egypt in Africa. But nonetheless, we're not too informed on that, so let us continue. So after Calexico is Hebre or Hebrew. And it's a small town. It's a crossing, right? So we have the Twin Cities, and then we have Hebron, or Hebrew, and then we have El Centro, the center. I mean, yeah, the center god or god center or god power, the Chayil. And so it's El Centro. It's where all the business goes down. Yeah, whatever. And then we have there's a few more cities, but more notably is it's the one that's more interesting. It's Westmoreland. So it's like there's more there's more Moors in the West, more Morenos or blacks even. So yeah, so it's like it's funny how it's Hebre, Hebrew, and then El Centro, and then Westmoreland. And so it's interesting. I don't know why there's a crown on top of Mount Sinai or Mount Zion. And it's interesting because it's actually called Mount Signal. Yeah, but everyone's in Rome, remember? So yeah, basically no one can get through, or at least Jah can't get through to Iandi, to some of Iandi. But yeah, just interesting. So it says here 1907, so you could do the math, 100 years. I mean, so it was established, I guess, like, I'm not great at math, but it would be, let's see, 2005. It's almost the 100-year anniversary is almost around the Ethiopian millennium. So, yeah, I just wanted to share on some of, today's mail. So give thanks. Shalom.